The bill, sponsored by the Deputy Chief Whip and Member Shelley Abubakar Isa, scaled top reading after a motion moved by the House Majority Leader Musa Mahmood and seconded by Member Vere Abdullahi Umari Apak. Thereafter, the Speaker of the House, who presided over the proceedings, directed the clerk to the House to communicate to executive arm following the passage of the bill. The Chairman, House Standing Committee on Education, and member representing Vere, Abdullahi Umari Apak, explained that the passage of the bill will pave way for the deduction of 1% from all contracts awarded by the state and local governments in the state to address the lean financial position of the state in reducing the problems of structural dilapidation of senior secondary schools, inadequate institutional facilities, as well as serve as special intervention measures to schools in the state.
So we in Adamawa State, we look inward. How are we going to solve the problem of secondary schools in Adamawa State? That's the essence of DP. So the House also resolved that we must provide 1% on all contracts that the state government either award or the local government, that 1% of that goes to the senior secondary school for the development of senior secondary schools. That's the main importance of in terms of this bill.
Abdullahi Apak is also optimistic that the bill, considering its importance, will be implemented through oversight with a view to realizing the objectives of the bill toward improving the education sector.
So after the executive assent from the bill, what measures are you going to follow to ensure that what is contained in the bill is implemented to the level?
Through oversight. That is the work of the legislature. It's been done through oversight.
The bill was conceptualized out of the glaring fact that almost all senior secondary schools in the state are structurally dilapidated without any form of assistance and interventions measures, as well as inadequate institutional materials, especially textbooks, referral books, scheme of work, stationaries, among others.
I want to assure them, you know, this bill took us almost five months before we got right from the inception to the culmination stage. And the secondary schools in Adamawa State have that interest. We are the representatives of the people. So we are saying this to senior secondary schools. It's going to be new thing in time. And if I have caught the governor right, he said he has declared state of emergency in the education sector. So we are going to take governor by his words. We are not going to leave him without implementing things. Once we pass anything in the education sector, we see that he implements that thing in the right time and in the right order.
With the passage of the bill into law, it will significantly address challenges of poor condition of senior secondary schools and institutional materials, among others. Abdullahi Ibrahim, 26 News.